Thank you all for coming. We also want to thank GEMS and St. Malachy's for putting us on. Those of you who have come to Empire Vitals concerts before probably know that we are thieves. Carlene and Arthur and I steal a lot of music that was originally written for other instruments, and this concert is no exception. That first piece, the Meister Passacaglia, was originally for two violins. And later on in the concert, we're going to play a W.F. Bach duo that was originally for two flutes. And the final piece was originally an organ trio sonata. However, the piece we're about to play is original for two viols, and it's sort of the basis for the title of this concert, The Rhine Journey, because Schenck called it the Nymphs of the Rhine. We don't know why. The piece is kind of Italian, and as far as I know, the Rhine doesn't really go to Italy, but that is what he called it. And maybe it's in contrast to a collection that he wrote a few years later, which was The Echoes of the Danube. I don't know. I also wanted to just mention that Carlene is playing a 7-string bass by David Rubio, and my 6-string bass is by Carl Dennis in Rhode Island. This instrument is a copy of a Tilke instrument from the late 17th century Germany, so it should be just right for the piece we're about to play.
Thank you. So Johann Jakob Froberger had to be one of the most colorful people who existed in the, certainly musicians and cultural ambassador who existed in the whole Baroque period. He was born in Stuttgart. He studied with Frescobaldi in Rome. He was mainly working for the imperial court in Vienna, but he was sent all over as an ambassador. He went to France, where he became friends with Louis Couperin. He went to England, we know that for a fact, and he also went to Brussels. And the, one of the reasons that we know this is that he recounted some of the, some of his exploits while traveling in his pieces. The Allemande, for example, one of the Allemandes that I'm not playing today talks about the fact that he went to England and he was robbed while crossing the Channel. And he hopes that the performers will play the piece better than the way he was treated by the robbers. In this particular piece, it's recounting a journey along the Rhine between Cologne and Mainz. And he was there with a certain count, with a number of his friends and the manservant of the count. And they must have had a whole evening, a whole night of partying. They finally got back to the ship at 5 in the morning. They find places to sleep. The manservant, unfortunately, has no place on the ship. There's not enough room. Has to go into the life raft. But then it's very uncomfortable with his dagger. So he takes the dagger out and attempts to give it to the one of the crew members of the ship. What do you think happens? He leans over with his dagger and falls into the water, into the Rhine. In which case, all of a sudden, there's a big commotion, lots of noise. Everybody's waking up and trying to figure out what to do about this. Poor guy who's fallen into the water. There's a lot of running around. Finally, Froberger himself wakes up, hears all the noise, nobody's near him, figures that the ship is probably sinking, and then prays for his salvation to God. That's the first 8 measures of the piece. After that, the crew's trying to save this poor guy. They find a long pole and try to fish him out with the pole. The first time they try this, all they manage to do is to rip the man's coat. And the second time, he gets, according to the narration, a vicious blow along his shoulders. He then gives up on trying to have the crew members save him, and he tries to swim in the Rhine, but the current is so strong that he, in fact, starts to sink, and then he again prays for his salvation. Finally, one of the crew members gets in the other life raft, goes along, and is able to save the fellow's life, and it's a very happy ending. That's that Allemande, which is 16 measures long. The other 3 movements have little snippets of this in it, but it's mostly that Allemande that has all that happening. Thank you.
No.
Thank you. Great thanks to the Empire Viols for this wonderful musical journey down the Rhine River, and to Rebecca Pachevsky for the use of this beautiful harpsichord on our series. My name is John Thiessen. I'm the executive director of Gotham Early Music Scene. Midtown Concerts are generously supported by the Howard Gilman Foundation, the New York City Department of Cultural Affairs, the New York State Council on the Arts, and you, our audience. Thank you. For our online viewers, please visit gemsny.org and show your support for this series by making a generous donation. Please join us next week for a truly multimedia experience. Hesperus presents Before Mickey, Early Cartoons and Early Music. Behind me, there will be a screen on which will be projected cartoons from the 1910s and 1920s, accompanied by a plethora of early instruments, so you won't want to miss that. It's next Thursday, 1:15, here at St. Malachy's Church, the Actors' Chapel, on West 49th between Broadway and 8th Avenue in beautiful Manhattan. Thank you. Thank you.